Welcome to What's Up Now. I'm your host, Scott Stewart, and on the show today, Elaine Ballas, Lawrence Hilton Jacobs, Sammy Hagar, Nicole Ho, Karen Runtowski in our comedy spotlight with Julie Kidd. But first, let's head on out to Hollywood for the Trevor Live benefit.
Because the Trevor Project has been doing such amazing work around supporting LGBTQ youth, and even some of the imagery that I've seen through the Trevor Project has made me feel so comfortable being myself and being open about who I am.
I love this organization. It was important for me to come because I want any LGBTQ kid who's out there who's afraid of fitting into society or wondering what other people are going to think of. I want them to watch this and see a straight cisgender dude saying what matters is you find your authentic self, you be you.
Just bringing awareness to, you know, the troubled youth and making sure that they have a voice and that they have a space to feel safe, I feel like is so important. I luckily, my family embraced me and loves me very much, and so I never had to deal with the kind of side effects of what some of these kids have to go through growing up and coming out to their parents. And so I love the idea of supporting any kind of cause that helps them, you know, understand their worth and their value and remind them that life is beautiful and that they were created exactly the way they needed to be.
You know, everyone's going through it. I think there's such a, in a way, there's such a sense of community that's formed from the sort of heavy clouds that have been hanging over us for the past 2 years.
As someone who is very deep in social media in a lot of my work, you notice that I believe there's so many things that young people are exposed to these days that we weren't used to when we were children. It's like information is happening to them at rapid lightning speed. So when they see something, they can take it as gospel truth. And imagine on Twitter, on Facebook, on Instagram, how much pressure that is already for just being a young person, let alone an LGBTQ person. So that compiled with the political climate is really a toxic environment for even us as adults to handle.
You know, our youth, it's a really, really delicate time for them. They're struggling to figure out their identity. They want to be their most authentic self. And oftentimes they're ridiculed for it. So this is a wonderful, wonderful organization that helps, you know, to let people understand that there is support out there.
More and more people who are disenfranchised have been attacked and are being attacked over and over again, and our humanity is up for legislation again.
Your story is a touching reminder as to why we're here, a reminder of the urgency to come together for such an important cause. And I'm really humbled to accept the 2020 Visionary Award.
I am so grateful that I was given this gift. I am so exhilarated to continue exploring it, to continue learning about us and our history, to continue living and loving, and to strive for the celebration of us in all of the spaces and ways that we deserve to be celebrated. So thank you so much.
Hi, I'm Elaine Ballas, and what's up now?
Please welcome actor, director, producer, writer, she does it all. This is Elaine Ballas. How are you, Elaine?
I am great, and I'm happy to be here.
You've had such an amazing career. How did you get your start?
Well, I think I just was born into it, meaning that when I was born, I just knew I had to be in show business. And so from the time I was 3 or 4 years old, my mom used to tell me all the time when we'd go to family dinners that afterwards everybody had to perform. So I was producing variety shows at 3.
Do you find it challenging, because I know you've played so many roles that were incredible, do you find it challenging playing a character that's not like you?
Oh, no, I think it's fun.
Yes.
It's such a challenge. I love it. But of course, my forte, I believe, and my love is comedy, because I think making people laugh is the greatest thing in the world.
Yes, and you made us laugh in a lot of movies. And you've done several Mel Brooks movies, right?
I did four, yes.
Four movies. Tell us those.
Well, I started off with Spaceballs, and I think I should have been in. I didn't know him, and he claims I was way too young, but I had already seen the movie 6 times. Was Blazing Saddles. It was my all-time favorite movie, and then Young Frankenstein. But those parts were so specific. And then after that, he did a few more. And finally, when he got to Spaceballs, I said, that's it, Mel. Either you put me in the movie or I'm showing up on the set every day until that's you right. decide to put me in it. So he finally acquiesced.
Yeah, must be nice to be. So any funny or interesting stories for being on the set that you can remember?
Well, you know, the one that I really remember, Mel's just amazing, but... As you know, I started off as a professional ice skater at age 8. And so when there was a big difference between amateur and pro, and you couldn't make any money at anything when I was skating. So the first movie I did with him, which was Spaceballs, he goes, okay, Elaine, now we're not going to talk about skating. Don't mention skating or anything. So I go, okay, fine. First thing, I get on the set, and they all knew that I, you know, knew Mel and was a friend of his. And then we get on the set, the actual set. This was in makeup. I get on the actual set, and Mel starts telling everybody, oh, you should see her skate. She's such a great skater. She's wonderful. And I go, wait, I thought we weren't mentioning that. He goes, you can't mention it. This is my set. I can mention whatever I want.
Did you have any role models in figure skating that you look up to, or even now, any skaters that you just love to watch?
Well, okay, I mean, there are so many good skaters. Janet Lynn, of course, and Dorothy Hamill, mm-hmm. and, you know, the ones that everybody knows that were so good. But skating nowadays is so different. It's like a
quads.
Real, yeah, it's a jump fest, and the body type is different. And I really miss, I think Dorothy Hamill was probably the last one who would do a beautiful spin, and she had beautiful jumps, and she had flow. All these positions now, we used to do some of those positions, but that was because you missed the spin.
What's you know? The leg up in the air?
I think maybe when I was eight.
And stuff when I was skating.
Yeah, the spirals and holding a beautiful layback, you know,
right.
to see the arch, not just the flexibility,
right.
but the actual arc of the spin,
yeah.
and a camel spin, just
yeah.
to see the beauty.
Now, you are so funny. Have you ever tried stand-up comedy?
You know, I did do stand-up a couple times, and I like stand-up, but I like sketch better, improv, because I love working off of people and seeing their reactions
right.
and stuff like that. Stand-up is, in a way, a lot like skating, because it's just... you and the ice for skating, and in stand-up, it's you and the audience,
right.
you know.
Yeah.
But I thought I should do it just to know what it was like.
I could see you having you'll be so successful with your own variety show, like a Carol Burnett show.
Do you know that's what I always wanted to do? And I even have it still written in my computer.
Yeah.
And sometimes when I'm looking through things, because I forget where I put it,
mm-hmm.
and then I find the variety show, because I still want to do it.
Right.
But
yeah.
I break it up a little bit with my Campy Lane webisodes,
mm-hmm.
and now it's the misadventures, because she's always at the wrong place at the right time. Hello, darling. And what can I do for you?
I want to be a star!
Hi, I would like to see a salesperson about joining the gym.
Mm-hmm.
Is there someone available?
Golden Shoe! Hi!
So tell us about this book and how we can get it.
Okay, they can go to my website, which is Elaine, E-L-A-I-N-E, Ballas, B as in boy, A-L-L-A-C-E.com. So that's really simple. They can go there and order it, and it'll be personally autographed.
Everybody needs a cheerleader, is that right?
Well, yes. And basically what it is, how it started, at first it was just going to be a gag gift, okay? But then we got into the pandemic, and then the civil unrest. And then I thought, the way they are reporting the news and what's happening in history, this is wrong. So what I did, without giving the entire book away, was wrote the book for people to write their truth and their story.
Oh.
And if it's in their handwriting, nobody can change it.
Any projects you're working on or that are coming up that you can tell us about?
Yes.
Inside Scoop, Elaine?
Inside Scoop. Well, I'm doing a movie called A Wonderful Life. Oh. And it's with a director, Jeff London, whom I've really wanted to work with for like 8 years. And he does wonderful romantic comedies in that it could be any two people that are in a relationship. Right. Any two, it doesn't matter. And I think the next one is going to be with a dog.
Oh my goodness, anything with a dog.
But there is a dog in it. And I think one of the producers has two dogs. I have a dog, and Jeff has a dog. So they're all going to be vying for the parts.
Oh, you know? Well, I have two dogs. Does that mean I can get in the movie? Come on, Elaine.
He is such a wonderful director for rom-coms. Ooh. And I've always, that was like my favorite. I always wanted to be Doris Day or somebody,
right.
You know,
yeah.
Who didn't, you know. And
but you were on Welcome Back, Carter. You were Juan Epstein's girlfriend, weren't you?
I was.
Can't get any better than Juan Epstein's girlfriend, right?
Well, other than, and I did do one show where it was with John Travolta. That was really fun. And it was before he became so, so big that, you know, but the nicest guy in the world.
Now, you have a lot of fans. Have you ever dated one?
No.
That's a no for that one. Now, we know in this business you don't always get every part you want. So how do you deal with rejection? Like, if you want something, you just don't get it. You just goodbye you and move on?
You know, I think it's different at different ages and different stages of your life.
That's
you
true.
Know, now it's like, your loss.
Right.
You know,
it is their loss.
Your loss.
I'm so glad you came down to visit.
And Mika,
you brought
had
Mika.
To be...
You brought me a book. I love her
right.
for the book. We're gonna see her career. What's the best way? Just Elaine Ballas. Check it out on social. We don't all care about the social media, but we want to see. Want to see what you're doing, right?
Right. Well, if they go to the website, they can see like other things,
okay.
And we'll put this on if we can.
Yeah.
When it's out there, we'll put it on my website so everyone can see this interview over and over again.
Well, when it's Elaine. One time ain't enough when you see an Elaine.
You have to do it more than once because you'll never understand everything I said.
She's my one and only Elaine Ballas.
You asked for it, we're doing it. We're going to crack open the safe for Sammy Hagar and friends in our celebrity video vault. Adopt the Arts is honoring legendary Red Rocker, Sammy Hagar. We're in Hollywood at Avalon. Are you ready to rock? The Red Rocker, you were being honored tonight. How exciting.
I think it's pretty cool too, but you know, I'm mainly here for the support, the event that guys like Matt Sorum are so kind to put on events like this and take care of kids. So. Help kids out. So that's what I'm here for, really. I'll collect the award. Okay, I got room on my shelf. Don't worry.
Yes, we're glad you're here. When you were a kid, did you play an instrument in school?
No, I did not. I wanted to play drums, and my school, they only had one drum set, and some other kid who could play beat me out of it.
Emmy Award winner. You're the host tonight, Jane,
yes,
right?
I am. This is Adopt the Arts, which is an organization I've been a part of since its inception with Matt Sorum and Abby Berman, and we supply art programs to LA County schools because they have been cut off. They've been on the chopping block, and so we have stepped up, and so far we financed two schools, and we've committed to arts programs in those two schools, and we hope to always add more schools, so that's why we're having this event.
So Adopt the Arts, we're going to raise the musicians tonight on stage, incredible.
Yes. Oh, I was just listening to them warming up. This is like the royalty of rock and roll behind us. Matt Sorum, Slash, all these guys that maybe you don't know their names, but you'll look at them and you'll hear the tunes that they're playing. You go, oh yeah, that guy.
Are you ready tonight to have a raise some money, Adopt the Arts?
That's what we're doing here. We're raising money for the kids because we want to keep music and art alive in the public school system. I've gotten a partnership with them for 7 years now. We've done over 1,000 kids and 1,000 instruments, and we're just keeping it going and trying to build this thing, and every year it gets bigger. and we take care of more kids, and it's just been awesome. And thank you to Sammy and all my friends that came out, Billy Gibbons and Phil Axe and Steve Lukather and the DeLeo brothers, Billy Duffy from The Cult, my old bandmate. Stevie Solis is here. We got Bernard Fowler from the Rolling Stones. Michael Anthony.
Oh my God, we can't forget about Michael.
From Van Halen and Chickenfoot. Oh, it's killer.
All right, how you doing, brother?
You brought a few friends, it looks like. I've never been with so many.
Look at us. Look at all those beautiful people. We got Stevie Solis. We got Phil X.
Hey, Phil.
We got Kenny.
Kenny.
We got Rob DeLeo. And that's Paul L.
Oh, my goodness. So you guys all are going to perform tonight?
Yeah, oh, hell yeah. Are you going to be there?
Yeah, we are here ready to film.
Don't leave now.
No, so you were on tour, now you produced an album in Montreal, yes, and now you flew in for this.
I came in this. I came in to hang out with all my friends.
Well, who would? Yeah, so Adopt the Arts. What do you think?
Well, this is what, my third time doing it? What did we raise? A couple few hundred thousand dollars. It's a good cause, good stuff. And you know, we actually, Matt's kind of on us year round, so it seems like I'm constantly coming out of pocket. So I'm just gonna keep it going.
So did you play an instrument in school or?
Yeah, I always played guitar. It was one of those things where it takes your mind off school. So I played, and my dad got me into it, but it was one of those, I just went home from school to play. But if they had like programs like, you know, we're supporting now, it would have been like so much cooler, you know?
Yeah. I'm gonna just get in the middle on this. I wanna ask, out of everybody here tonight, who are you most excited to perform with? Can you pick one or two?
No, everybody. I like to play with everyone. Right? There is no one.
There is not one. This is a group, right?
Me, myself.
Everyone
is, all your best friends?
They're my good friends, and they're badass musicians. Yeah. There's no one.
Right.
They're all good.
So now it's
crazy. Here's what's crazy.
What's crazy?
It's what's really crazy. Okay, we all met like in the late 80s and we were all really young. And now we're all old as dirt and we've all played all the big places year after year and we're still in the game. And the best thing is if you're still alive, that's the best thing. And then the second thing is just we're still in the game. And so every time we do these things and we get to see each other, it's kind of like, oh, thank God we're all still alive and we're still rocking and rolling. So it's like, for us, it's really fun. And it's a good cause, so.
Yeah, this cause definitely brought us together. I mean, we never get to be all together at one time. It's impossible. Everyone's working. Yeah. So this brought us all together, which is outstanding.
Yeah.
I mean, I've known these guys for a long time. You'd never see them because everyone's busy.
Yeah, we always run into each other. We always like, I run into him on the airplane to Tokyo, and I run into him when we play at the K-Walk Rini Roast, and run into Phil X when he's with Bon Jovi on a private jet, and he don't talk to me no more.
So are you ready to put on a concert tonight?
Yeah, and what a great event, what a great cause, help kids, you know, keep music alive in schools. I went to I'm gonna date myself here, to the original Fame School in New York. We didn't dance on the tables like in the movie, but it was, it was great for kids like me who didn't quite fit in, and maybe, it gave me an opportunity to express myself, and they've proven that, you know, not only does music help kids learn a craft, but it helps in behavioral studies and also with attention deficit. It just gives kids a way to express themselves.
Nice. Yeah, when I was in school, we had it. Now, I guess these kids, it's hard to get it in the schools now.
Well,
they get the money.
What I understand, yeah, and Matt Sorum has been great, and, a lot of the money goes directly to the teachers, and, I don't know where I'd be without great music teachers in my school.
So how was it performing with Billy Idol for all that time?
It's
amazing.
Yeah, I mean, we're going on 35 years. We're heading out to Europe, and then there might be some U.S. dates.
Yeah.
It's unheard of in my business to last that long. Guitar player and singers, notoriously have a, sometimes volatile relationship. Yeah. We don't have that, We all travel together. I think that's the punk rock thing about him. He doesn't want to be, elitist away from the band or any of that. He loves hanging with his band, and he's just an awesome person.
Yeah, and he's still got the voice, man. I hear him, see him on TV, and I go, whoa.
And the apps.
He's got the voice and the apps. Yeah, I'm very proud of him, man. He's awesome.
Well, thank you for being here tonight, raising money, Adopt the Arts.
You know what? We're What's Up Orange County, and I remember seeing you at the fairground like 5 years ago. Remember?
Sure do. That's where Gilly learned to drive three-speed on the floor.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah. Had a nice little 32 Ford Roadster. She slid behind the wheel and said, what do I do with this thing? I said, pull back, hold on.
I heard you guys a little bit in there ready to go. It's like, ba-da-bum.
What did you think?
I don't know. It's going to be amazing, of course.
Okay, all right.
How can you add on? When I see everybody on stage, it was like the who's who. I mean, I can't even, the intro, I was trying to say what bands were here tonight representing. Right. Two list is too long.
It's a long list. Oh, it's
yes.
A long list.
We are ready to see you. Hey, what about school? Did you play an instrument in school?
I was a drummer in school, actually. I was in band in school. Yeah, yeah. I mean, what Matt's doing here is a great thing, because without music in schools, without the music programs, I wouldn't be here.
Now, when you were in school, did you guys play any instruments?
I had every music class that there was in public school. I really believe in this cause wholeheartedly. It made me a better person, a better musician.
What a great time here in Hollywood at Avalon. All the musicians, all the bands, all the money, all for Adopt the Arts. I know you're ready to laugh, so that's why we brought in comedian Julie Kidd.
It's time for What's Up Now Comedy Spotlight. I'm Julie Kidd, host and producer of The Funniest Housewives, and right now we're bringing to the stage our hippie housewife, Karen Rontowski.
Woo! The other day I put on an old coat, I reached in the pocket, there were like 70 Kleenex, some Pop Rocks, and some Vaseline, and I thought, I don't even want to remember what happened there. Was that? Probably didn't work in my favor, whatever the hell that was. I get confused. The other day I was sure the aliens had implanted a tracking device in me, but it just turned out to be a loose Frito in my underwear. So now I have to figure out why the aliens are putting Fritos in my underwear. That's terrifying. I was at a UFO conference, and this lady comes up to me and she goes, you have alien DNA. And I said, tell me more. And she said, there's a race of aliens, they're called Palladians. They're a peace-loving people with smooth skin, and they're beautiful. You're not one of those. Apparently I'm from Orion, we don't get along with anyone. And then she said, actually, you're a captain in the Orion Interplanetary Army. And I said, finally, someone has taken me seriously. So I immediately called my sister and I said, hey, I just found out I'm a captain in the Orion Interplanetary Army. And she said, Orion is a constellation, not a planet. And I said, really? That's all you saw wrong with that statement?
I love alien comedy, but some people call me a little spacey. But isn't Karen's sense of humor out of this world?
Lawrence Hilton Jacobs has a new TV show and movie coming out. I caught up with Lawrence to talk about it.
So what have you been up to?
I mean, work-wise, I've been doing a streaming series called A House Divided on All Black TV, and it also plays on Amazon Prime. It's been going for 3 years. And the next month I'm doing a movie called Night Stalker, which is about a serial killer. I'm playing a tough cop.
Ooh, is that fun?
Yeah, it's fun. That's why I'm growing in the dust.
Bones in the dust, yeah.
And, I cut the hair short, you know.
Yep,
yeah. So,
yeah, you're still looking the same as when you were on Welcome Back Carter.
My birthday was last Sunday. I turned 69, brother.
Okay,
yeah. Yeah, man, that's real.
Welcome back, where your dreams are your ticket out. Welcome back to the same old place that you laughed about. Well, the dreams have changed.
Hi, I'm Nicole Ho, USA International Miss 2023. What's up now?
Please welcome USA International Miss 2023, Nicole Ho. How are you?
Doing good. Thank you so much for having me here today.
Yes, you are, of course, extremely beautiful. And I heard you recently went to Vietnam representing, yes. Showing, did you wear the crown in Vietnam for everybody to see? Who is she?
Oh my gosh, yes, crown and sash.
Do it up.
To represent USA International Miss 2023.
So have you been doing pageants very long?
Not long, actually. I just did my first one in 2021, where I competed for Miss Teen Asia USA.
Uh-huh.
And I won the title, so, you know.
Do you win them all? Is that the trick?
Oh, no, no, no.
Yes, I heard you are also a concert pianist.
Yes, I am. So I have been playing since I was 2, and I want to thank all of my accomplishments. They are because of my amazing piano teacher, Molly Nguyen, and because of her, I've had the opportunity to play at New York's Carnegie Hall.
Really?
And halls in Paris and Vienna, so it's been an amazing journey.
I think we should thank the piano teacher, but we might want to thank your parents too,
oh,
right?
Yes.
Because they were the ones that probably got you started, right?
That's very true. That's very true. We have to thank Mom and Dad.
We got to thank Mom. Yes, your mother, by the way, she was a beauty pageant winner herself, right? A title holder?
Yes, yes. So she won Miss America International in 2011.
Wow. And is there a charity I think that you help your mom with?
Yes, there is. So we do run Warm Hearts Mission Charity nonprofit together, and it's been going since 2011, and ever since we've been feeding impoverished communities, homeless communities throughout Southern California, as well as areas in Vietnam.
Is there a website or anywhere they can go to try to donate?
Yes, so we are, we're on Facebook, we're on Instagram, at Warm Hearts Mission.
Oh, yeah. Good. So what have you done so far representing USA International Miss?
So far this year, we've been able to partner with Los Angeles Mission down in downtown LA, and we did a Thanksgiving drive with them where we served over 3,000 homeless. And in addition to that, we went to Vietnam, like we did speak about earlier, and we visited an orphanage as well as a village in Hue. So we did give back to the community there. And I've been able to have some fun with the Lunar New Year just this past February, where I did a parade and some photo shoots. So it's been great.
I'm telling you, this Ashy Crown are looking good on you, that's for sure.
Thank you very much.
I will be taking off.
Thank
when you want
you.
That, I won't sleep with that on.
No, oh, yeah. I slept with it for the first couple nights.
I've been wondering about that. Any message you would want to pass along to the next USA International Miss?
I think one thing to really remember is just to be grounded and be, you know, grateful for everything that we have today. And also just remember that it's a journey and you don't have to be perfect, but definitely remember who you are throughout this journey.
Over the next year, 2 years, any goals you have for yourself?
Well, right now I'm in university studying biology and on the pre-med track. So I really hope I can succeed with that. And I really hope this coming year with my reign as USA International Miss will be a successful and one for the books.
Hey, your mom being a previous pageant title holder, did she give you a lot of help?
A lot of guidance, encouragement, definitely. It was so helpful.
Yeah, now go play piano. I love it. Want to play? What about singing? Do you sing any at all?
Only for fun.
I was going to ask you to sing your song, but
oh,
I guess
no.
We won't. But maybe we're going to take some, I want to look at some footage. We're going to check her out playing the piano. Nicole Ho, thank you so much for being on the show.
Thank you so much, Scott.
Well, all good things must come to an end, but be sure to check us out on the internet where you can watch videos, see exclusive photos, and contact us about being on the show. Until next time, I'm your host, Scott Stewart, and that's What's Up Now.
What's up now? What's up now? My favorite. Tune in.
What's up now?
What's up now? And if you're not watching it, you better.
What's up now?
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 What's up now?